Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Shanti Bhushan, comma, learned senior counsel appearing for the appellant submitted that the High Court has gravely erred in declining the anticipatory bail to the appellant full stop. He submitted that Section 438 CRPC was incorporated because sometime influential pupil try to implicate their rivals in false cases for the purpose of disgracing them or for other purposes by getting them detained in jail for some days full stop. He pointed out that in recent times, comma, with the accentuation of political rivalry, comma, this tendency is showing signs of steady increase, full stop. The submitted that the appellant has been implicated in a false case and apart from that he has already joined the investigation and he is not likely to abscond or otherwise misuse the liberty while on bail, comma, therefore, comma, there was no justification to decline anticipatory bail to the appellant full stop. Mr. Bhushan also submitted that the FIR in this case refers to an incident, comma, which had taken place on the instigation of the appellant 8 years days ago, full stop. According to him, comma, proper analysis of the averments in the FIR leads to irresistible conclusion that the entire prosecution story seems to be a cock and bull story and no reliance can be placed on such a concocted version, full stop. Mr. Bhushan contended that the personal liberty is the most important fundamental right guaranteed by the Constitution, full stop. He has submitted that it is the fundamental principle of criminal jurisprudence that every individual is presumed to be innocent till he or she is found guilty, full stop. He further submitted that on proper analysis of Section 438 CRPC, comma, the legislative wisdom becomes quite evident that the legislature wanted to preserve the and protect personal liberty and give impetus to the aged old principle that every principal is presumed to be innocent till he is found guilty by the court, full stop. Mr. Bhushan also submitted that an order of anticipatory bail does not in any way, comma, directly or indirectly, comma, take away from the police their power and right to fully investigate into charges made against the appellant, comma, He further submitted that when the case is under investigation, the usual anxiety of the investigating agency is to ensure that the alleged accused should fully cooperate with them and should be available as and then when they require him. Full stop. In the instant case, when the appellant has already joined the investigation and is fully cooperating with the investigating agency, then it is difficult to comprehend why the respondent is insistent for custodial interrogation for the appellant. Full stop. According to the appellant, in the instant case, the investigating agency should not have a slightest doubt that the appellant would not be available to the investigating agency for further investigation, particularly when he has already joined investigation and is fully cooperating with the investigating agency. Full stop. Mr. Bhushan also submitted that according to the General Clauses Act 1897, the court which grants the will also has the power to cancel it, and the grant of will is an interim order. Full stop. The court has always reviewed its decision according to the subsequent facts, circumstances and new material. Full stop.